Hi everyone again. In this video, I'll show you how to do what you just saw using only PowerPoint, so keep watching. The main principle for how to do this is what I call layering slides. I'll first show you how to do this with a very basic animation, and then I'll show you how to do everything that you saw in the video. Okay, let's just start with that first slide and have that circle move to the right side and expand by 30%. Then we duplicate the slide and move the circle ourselves to the right and increase the size by 30% so that the second slide looks exactly the same as the end state of the first slide. From here, we can do other things like moving it back to the left, splitting it, and making it into a weird looking little bug. Now we again duplicate the slide, the orange lines stay there, and we need to line up the circle halves to be on each side so it again looks like the end state of the previous slide. From here, we can group the shapes and have them exit the slide. And when you put all three slides together, they create a seamless animation as you see here. Here is a detailed breakdown of what each slide looks like with the animation paths. The reason that you always try to duplicate slides rather than create them from scratch is so that the objects that stay on the next slide are exactly lined up and serve as guides for where to put the other stuff, for example, the orange lines. So this technique was basically how I created most of the animations in the video, and now I'll go through each animation one by one so you can see the details. The so and the dots here are simply text boxes with a whip effect on the so and a wipe effect on the dots. The circle is actually four separate pieces to make the animation smoother. Each of these has a wipe effect with the directions of left, down, down, and right. And here are the animation timings just so you can see them quickly. And here's what it looks like. Now we need to shrink the circle to 70% of its original size. So let's use the layering technique and make a duplicate slide first, then we'll turn it into a picture so we can shrink it easier. To do this, we copy everything, paste as picture, line it up exactly to the original, then cut out the picture on top, delete the original, then paste the picture. In this way, the pasted picture version is exactly in the same spot as the original. Now we add the grow shrink animation and change it to 70%. Let's again duplicate the slide, copy the circle, shrink the pasted one to 70%, line it up, and delete the original. Now let's add the text. And you can get the curved effect by going to Word Art Styles, and you can customize it with the purple dot there. This will have a zoom animation, and to have the so disappear, we add a black circle with a fade effect on top. And let's add an about in there with a swivel effect. And here's what we get. Okay, now we're going to flip this over. So duplicate the slide, group everything, but it looks really weird if you add a spin because the axis of rotation is higher than you want it. To fix this, let's change the axis by copying and flipping the circle over, lining it up symmetrically, making it black and invisible, sending to back, then grouping with the original. Now the spin looks a lot better. And let's just change the spin settings to 180 degrees counterclockwise. Now we duplicate the slide and flip everything to match the end of the last slide. Let's add the other half of the text with a spinner animation and duplicate the slide again, group everything, and add a shrink effect to 20%, then a motion path down and remove the smooth start and end. And let's add a question mark with a fade effect. I cropped out the bottom dot here to make room for the circle. And here's what it looks like. Let's duplicate the slide and our question mark will serve as our anchor point. We'll have to shrink the circle to 20%. And here comes the tricky part. We now have to place it exactly where it ended up on the last slide. So we put it about where we think and then view in presentation mode to compare the original to the duplicate. See how the duplicate jumped up and to the left? We now have to adjust it to be down and right. And let's compare again. Not 100% perfect, but definitely close enough. On the same slide, let's insert the L, which is just two grouped rectangles with a boomerang entrance. For the rolling effect, add a motion path to the circle and also a clockwise spin. Have them both start right after the L boomerangs in. At this time, the question mark sinks down as well, and here's what it looks like all together. Now we add the rest of the text to the slide. The ets and the do have a whip effect and the it has a zoom effect. Finally, we put the circle on top of the eye with a bounce entrance. Looks a little messy, but this is the final effect. And to make it all break up and fly away, use a vortex transition. For the next sequence, we'll insert a the with a boomerang entrance and then a counterclockwise quarter spin. Then we'll put best in here with a fly in effect and way to with a curve up effect. Then add the learn blocks in here. To make them look like kids blocks, I just added a really fat outside line. And these have a bounce entrance with a stagger timing to create this effect. So to make these exit, we first duplicate the slide. Everything is the same except the gets rotated. And you have to use trial and error to line it up to the last slide, as I showed you before. Now you just group both sections, and the exit effects are a diagonal boomerang on top, and a slight up, and a swivel arc on the bottom. And here it is. For this sequence, the is and the to are just text boxes with a zoom effect. The watch with a wipe entrance is put on top so that the T and the C line up with the to. The T and C are then blackened out, and the watch text box is sent to the back. To create a C from the O, I put a black triangle there with a vertical split effect. The trick here is timing, because the triangle has to appear right when the C would appear in watch. For the next sequence, we duplicate the slide again, copy and paste everything as a picture, cut in half, and line up to the original. And do the same for the bottom half. And delete the original guide so you just have the two halves there. Okay, to create the film strip effect, we put three rectangles on top of each other with a wipe entrance. The bottom is just black, and the two on top are white rectangles with black holes. The white strip on top and the bottom half of the text both have a downward motion path, so it looks like this. Now add the white bars with a wipe entrance, so now it all looks like this. As you may have guessed, the next step is duplicating the slide and moving things down to align to the last slide. Then we group the top half and bottom half and add a float up and float down exit effect. Now we add a, lot, and of to the boxes with a zoom effect, so it all looks like this. Duplicating the slide again, we extend the film strip off the screen by copying and pasting, then add videos for inspiration, and group everything. And now we're ready to have this scroll across the screen with a motion path to the left. Okay, now we duplicate the slide again and scroll the film strip across to the left to look like the end of the last slide. Again, I had to use trial and error here to get it just right. Now we add the next part, which is a black floral box with a wipe entrance coming in from the left. And next we have a zigzag line, which is just rectangles grouped together, and that'll wipe from the top. To create that pull-away effect you see after the zigzag comes down in the video, we need to make the right side of the film strip a picture with the zigzag line on the edge of it on the left. Here we'll use a very caveman technique that I've shown in other videos. We cut and paste into paintbrush, draw in gray around the zigzag area, copy-paste again, click on Color Options, set Transparent Color, and click on the gray. And now we line this up with the zigzag and send to the back to make the edge look clean. This pasted picture will fade in as the zigzag line goes down, but should not be visible. Here is what it should look like. Now let's duplicate the slide, and we need to invert the colors on the left side here. Let's start by sending the left side to the back, which I've already done. Now format background to make it white, and you can see that the picture we made before is on the right side. The film strips are actually pictures, so I'll change them to black and format picture. Now we can take out this black background here and make the floral pattern black. Since it's a vector image, I can just recolor it like any other shape. Let's just add the fly out exit animation to make it go like this. For the next sequence, we duplicate the slide and take out the right side. Let's put in the however, and let's paste two identical black film strips on the top and bottom. They're going to be coming in and basically switching spots with each other. I actually have another tutorial that covers a similar trick if you want more details on this. Basically, the floral background is exiting with a split effect while the film strips are switching places. At the same time, the however is appearing with a split effect, as you can see here. Duplicate the slide, and I've already removed the floral background to match the last slide. I've also changed the motion paths on the film strip, so they're going into the middle like this. Once they get there, a black bar will fade in so that it'll look like a solid line. Again, the however is exiting with a split while the lines are coming together. Now we duplicate the slide again and add a split exit animation to make it go like this. Now we add three more lines to make the eye. The middle one will fade in as the longer line contracts, and then will rotate, and then the other two lines will split out, like so. Duplicate the slide again, and let's recolor to orange. Add the WLL as a text box to the wipe entrance. We also add downward motion paths to both the WLL and the eye, so it looks like this. Now we're ready to add the show with a wipe down entrance after the motion paths. We also add a red W at the bottom to fade in to replace the blue one. It then looks like this. Now we add a U to go across the O with a wipe entrance. The trick here is just timing everything right so it's all in sequence. Now we're ready to duplicate again, and once again using trial and error, we bring down the will so that it matches the last slide. Now group everything and add a motion path to the left so it goes like that. Duplicate the slide again and move everything to the side. Change the S color and add the several so it looks like this. Duplicate the slide again and let's add a shrink animation to 75%. Duplicate again. Copy and paste as an image because we can't shrink fonts. Decrease it to 75% and line it up to match the last slide. Now we insert tricks in here with a wipe down entrance. Insert the to and the get as well. Now duplicate the slide, group everything, and now we add both a motion path and a grow animation, increasing it to 150%. Duplicate the slide. I've already lined it up to match the last slide, but this took a while because I had to increase the size and also move it sideways. Now we sort of reverse this and go back to the left and shrink it down. You also add the started to line up with the bottom S in tricks. You can see how it lines up right here. Now the S will do a little kick, which is done with a 10 degree clockwise spin. Right afterwards, the top group will exit with a shrink and turn effect. Okay, the last part, the explosion sequence. We've duplicated the slide and the started is still there, but it's covered with white shapes and red explosion clouds, which are just groups of red rectangles. Maybe if I change the background here, you'll see better. Basically, what happens is that for each letter to explode, a white shape goes over it, the explosion cloud appears, and then expands. At the end, these simply converge in the middle and shrink and turn to exit. Now for the enjoy sequence, you can get details of how to do this in one of my other videos, but basically the lines switch places and then disappear while the letters enter with a split effect. At the end, they all spiral out to look like this. Thanks a lot for watching. Hopefully this was helpful to you, and see you again soon.